The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 20, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 14th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Material nature and the living entities should be understood to be beginningless. Their transformations in the modes of nature are products of material nature.
So there were six questions by Arjuna. Khetra, khetravya, jnanam, jnayam, prakriti, purusha. Six questions. The Krishna has already replied. What is khetra, khetravya, and what is the process of knowledge, and what is the object of knowledge? Now he is beginning to explain what is this material nature and what is these living entities. Material nature, prakriti, is enjoyable. Prakriti means enjoyable. And purusham means enjoyer. Just like in our present condition, we accept the female as a fair sex, enjoyer. And we, male, we think we are enjoyer. By nature, the female that by nature have to dress attractive, and the purush is attractive. So this prakriti and purush, actually, none of us are purusha. This conception of purusha, enjoyer, that is there in so-called woman and so-called man. The man also wants to enjoy. Not only man, every living entity, cats, dogs, trees, aquatics, everyone. Because this material world means all the living entities, beginning from Lord Brahma down to the smallest ant, they are seeking after enjoyment. Purusha, that is purusha spirit. One who is seeking for enjoyment is called purusha. But actual purusha is Krishna. We are all prakritis. And because being prakriti, we are trying to become purusha, that is called maya or illusion. Just like if a woman dresses like a man and wants to act as man, and that is illusion. Similarly, we are differently dressed in the material ingredient, bhumi, rapana, vayu. Everyone's body is made of these five elements, and mind, intelligence, they are also subtle material elements, and with this combination, we have got this body, and I am the spirit soul, I am trying to endure. This is material world. We have forgotten that we are part and parcel of Krishna. Our business is not to endure, but to help Krishna to endure. That's our business. Part and parcel. We have given several times this example. Just like these fingers, they are my part and parcel of the body. The finger catches a nice sweet meat. It is not the business of the fingers to enjoy the sweet meat, but it gives to the mouth, to go to the stomach for enjoyment. So, it is the duty of the part and parcel of God to help him enjoy. That is bhakti. Bhakti means anukullena krishnanu silanam. Anukul means favorable. Krishna Rusilano, Krishna consciousness. Always thinking how to make Krishna happy. That is all. Anukulino Krishna Rusilano. That the gopis, the first class example, and the gopis, or the inhabitants of Vrindavan, they are all trying to make Krishna happy. That is Vrindavan. If here also, if you try to make Krishna happy, this can be converted into Vrindavan. But that attitude we have got. We have got, by the influence of Maya, we have become Purusha. Who you want to enjoy? Why is Krishna surrender? I surrender. I am Krishna. I am God. This is the way. So, the endeavor is this matter, this material world. And the living entities, they are trying to enjoy. They are not actually enjoying. They are suffering. They are becoming entangled. Because by this enjoying spirit, we are developing different types of mentality, and at the time of death, according to that mentality, I get the next birth. That means, by this enjoying spirit, I am getting entangled. I am not becoming free. If I live like dogs, dog mentality, then naturally at the time of death, my mentality will be like a dog, and naturally I get a dog's body. Then I enjoy, the dog is also enjoying. They forget. The animals, the ant is also enjoying, and not Brahma is also enjoying. So this purusha spirit is material life. So that purusha means the living entity. Krishna says here, the prakritiṃ purusaṃ caiva viddhi anādi, eternal. It is not temporary, it is eternal. There are five things. The living entities, the prakriti, God, and the work, there are prakritiṃ purusaṃ caiva viddhi anādi. Anādi means eternal. It is not created, it is there, but it becomes manifested. Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, bhūtā bhūtā praliya. Another example, just like this body, my body, your body. I have got this body, you have got this body. This body will be destroyed. Avinashi to Sandhya Vibdhi, Jena Sarva Vidam Tatam. But my that consciousness will not be destroyed. This body will be destroyed. But my consciousness will not be destroyed. That is stated in the Bhagavad. Avinashi to Sandhya Vibdhi, Jena Sarva Vidam Tatam. Vidam Tatam. Vidam, this body. He is spread with consciousness. If you pinch any part of your body, you will become conscious that it is painful. But how long it is painful? So long the soul is there. And as soon as the soul is gone, you chop it with a dagger, it will not respond. Therefore, avinashi tu tad viddhi, jena sarva vidam. That thing, that consciousness, is obvious. The so-called scientists, they do not know that the consciousness is eternal and it carries me to another body. I see that this body is destroyed, therefore finish, I'll finish. No. You have got practical experience. When you sleep, the body does not work. But the consciousness was. You therefore dream in a different atmosphere. You get a different body and enjoy a different dream. Every day we have got experience. At night I forget this body. And daytime I forget the dreaming body. So this is also dreaming. At daytime. because I forget. At night, I saw that I was a king, I was ruling over somebody, or I was lecturing as a political leader, and this time I see that I am a clerk, neither politician nor king. So I forget the night's body, and at night I forget this body. Similarly, change of body means I forget this body. Last life I had some body, but I cannot say what kind of body I had. Of course there is science, astronomy and other things. They can speak, but I don't believe it. Or even if I believe, what can I do with that? So we are changing. But the consciousness is not avinashi. Avinashi. So because the consciousness is not changed, it is creating another body according to consciousness. Just like we create favorable circumstances to enjoy even in this life. Why the struggle for existence? We are trying to make a favorable condition for enjoyment. This is struggle for existence. Nobody is satisfied with the present position. Everyone is struggling for. But he does not know that any material arrangement, according to my intelligence, will never make me happy. That is you know. Therefore Krishna says, you rascal, nonsense, give up this business. Sarva dharman purityajya. You are rascal number one, you have forgotten your constitutional position. Now you give up all these engagements. If you want to be happy, māmi kaṁ saranam, just be under my control. And what benefit I shall derive? Aham tvā sarva pāpe mamokkhaśyāmi, māsu. I will be protected. Because in suffering for your sinful activities, everything is sinful activities. Everything. Just like a gang of thieves. A gang of thieves, after plundering booties from some gentleman's house, they came outside the village and they were dividing. So one of these thieves is saying, sir, let us divide it honestly. Let us divide the booty honestly. Now their basic principle is dishonesty. Now they want to divide honestly. So all these rascal politicians, they are all dishonest and they are trying to make adjustment honestly. Honest. What is dishonesty? There cannot be honesty. Harava bhaktasya puto mahaguna. Anyone who is not a devotee of the Lord, he cannot be possessing any good quality. That is not possible. He must be dishonest. If he is not devotee of the Lord, he must be dishonest. This is the bhārita viśāstra. Kṛṣṇa bhūyā jīv bhoga vañcā kare pāśate māyātare jāpotiya dhare. This is a Bengali poetry. It says, as soon as we forget the real enjoyer, and we want to enjoy immediately, that is called maya. And as soon as we give up this mentality, that is confirmed by Bhagavad Gita. Mancha vyabhicharini bhakti yogena ja sevate sagunam samapritta etan brahma bhuyayatantu. As soon as you give up this mentality, that I am the enjoyer, as soon as we change our mentality, that Krishna is in there, then immediately become liberated. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Abhyavicharini bhakti yoga na ja sevate sab gunan samatitta yena. Yet it is also said, vikaramsa gunan seva vidhi prakiti sambhava. We have become servants of the three gunas. Three qualities of this material world. Somebody is very proud of becoming good, goodness, like Brahmana quality. That is good. in the material world, that is first class quality. The second class quality, passionate, very active. All people are very active for enjoyment, passionate. And some people are in ignorance. They do not know what is goodness and what is passion. They can simply waste their time by laziness and sleeping. So actually, we are all sleeping because we do not know what is the aim of life. At night we sleep, we forget that what is my duty, what is my business, what I have to do. Everything we forget. Similarly, so long we are in ignorance, that is our sleeping stage. Therefore, the Vedic mantra is Uttisthata Jagrata Praptavaran Nibodhata. Now you have got the human form of life. Do not sleep like animals, cats and dogs. Get up. That is Vedic mantra. Tamasima Jyotirgama. Don't remain in this darkness. Just come forward to the Jyoti. Jyoti means, that is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita, Najatram Hasayati Surya. No sasanta, no pavaka, jadgatyala nivartanti tadnamam paramam mama. Everything is there. Here you require the sunlight, the moonlight, the electricity, but there is another nature, paraspasmattu bhava anya, bhaktya bhaktya sanatana. There is no need of sun, there is no need of moon, because each and every planet is illuminated. Jagatyana nivartanta. And if you go there, then you do not come back again in this material world, which is dukkhadam asasatam napnuvanti mahatmanam samsiddhim paramangataha. So our aim should be how to go back to home, back to God. But we do not know. We are simply acting like cats and dogs, that's all. Jumping like dog, cat, and eating, sleeping, and having sex intercourse, and trying to defend my position. These things are done by the animals. These things are done by animals. Then what is your benefit? You get this human form of life. Shastra says, Tapodibvam putraka jena suddheta satya. Jasmād brahma-sokham manantam nāyam divati-bhājānalu kastāna-kāmāna-arhati-vīrhu-jānti. This human form of life is not meant for working very hard like cats and dogs. It is meant for tapasya. Tapasya, simple life. And realize yourself. And then you stop the miserable condition of your life. Tapo dibbam jina suddhita satya. Just like when you are diseased, we go to the physician and try to cure the disease. Similarly, we do not know what is our main disease. That is explained by Krishna previously. Janma mittu jaradvyadi. This is our real disease. To take birth, to die, to become old, and to become victims of disease. But nobody knows how to cure this. And he still is very much proud of becoming advanced in education and civilization. This is called illusion. This is called illusion. Real disease is how to stop. Ganga, Krishna has repeatedly said, Taptadiham punarjanmanaiti mahamiti kaunteva. Janma karma vidibham jyujyanati. Simply try to understand me, Krishna. The result will be kakkadiham. That is, after this giving of this body, we have to accept another body. Krishna says, simply if you understand me in truth, then thereafter, no more accepting any material body. You remain in your spiritual body and come to the spiritual world, back to home, back to God. So, here, Prakriti Purusham Chaiva, although Prakriti is also Krishna's nature, Bhumi Rapanana Vayu Khamamana Uddhi, he says, Aparayam, this is inferior nature. So, aparayam itastu vidhi me pratitim para. Another superior nature there is. What is that? Jiva mukha, the living entity. So we are also pratiti. And the material nature is also pratiti. This is inferior pratiti. And we are superior pratiti. As we are now under the control of this inferior prakriti, we can transfer ourselves under the control of the superior prakriti. That superior prakriti is spiritual world. This material world means it is made of this inferior prakriti, bhumira paanar world. And there is another prakriti, sanatana, that is stated in Bhagavad Gita, I'll find in 8th chapter. Parastasmatu bhava anya. Bhava means nature. Vapyavapya sanatana. Sanatana means that is not destroyed. And this prakriti is destroyed. Bhutta bhutta praliyate. So bhutta bhutta praliyate means that prakriti is had, but the manifestation is temporary. It is not false. Just like he will become sometimes angry, so you show some symptom. That symptom is within you, but it is manifested sometime. Sometimes it is not manifested. But the propensity, the quality of your becoming angry is there eternally. It is not that it is created. Anything. Sometimes you become passionate. To become passionate, it is there. It is not a new thing. But it sometimes appears, sometimes disappears. Similarly, this material world, this is also prakriti of Krishna. The fact is that it is sometimes manifest, sometimes not manifest. Just like the cloud. Cloud is a fact. But sometimes it is manifest, sometimes it is not manifest. When it is not manifest, you cannot say cloud is false. No. It is a fact. But the nature is sometimes manifest, sometimes not manifest. So here Krishna says, prakritim purusachaiva, vidhi anadi, they are eternal. Krishna is eternal, and the living entities are eternal, and the prakritis are also eternal. They are not false. But they are manifested sometimes, not manifested. And when we do not like to obey Krishna, we cannot live in the spiritual world. In the spiritual world, there is no such thing, disobedience. There is always, they are all devotees. Just like in Vrindavan, they are all devotees of Krishna. Somebody is serving Krishna's father and mother, Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda. Somebody is serving as friend, somebody is serving as servant, somebody is serving as a conjugal lover. In this way, there are five different kinds of service, nello. Whatever you like. Everybody is not like it. That is test. I like to serve Krishna as a conjugal lover. I like to love Krishna as my son. I like to love Krishna as my friend. I like to love Krishna as my master. I simply love Krishna by glorifying him. These are pancha, five kinds of rasa. Santa, dasa, sakha, vatsala, man. So you can select any one of them. Because there must be varieties. Because we are living entities. Everyone we want to enjoy. Therefore, variety is the manner of enjoyment. You cannot make everything impersonal. No. There is varieties. Even in the spiritual world, there is varieties. That varieties are reflected in this material world. Therefore, here also, we love somebody as friend, we love somebody as wife, we love somebody as father, we love somebody as mother, like that. The same thing is pervasively reflected. And because it is illusion, therefore you are not satisfied. If you want real love, real position, then you have to transfer your this loving propensities in five different kinds of mellows to Krishna. Then it will be permanent and it will be happy. don't reject this as because he could not capture the grace, then the grace and the jackals. The jackal, you know that story. The jackal went to steal some grapes in the orchard and it was very high. He jumped over several times. He could not get it. Then he rejected, oh, this is sour, I don't know. Similarly, his Mahavadi philosophy is like that. First of all, he wants to become a very big man, very big businessman, minister, this, that. Simply endure. Competition of India. But when he bungled, when he did not endure, simply suffered, he comes to his knowledge that I could not endure, I simply suffered, then it is mithya, grapes are sour. That philosophy is not true. You must know that this prakriti, this material world, you are not enjoyer. The enjoyer is Krishna. Sarva loko maheshwara. If you want to become enjoyer, then you are thief. You cannot be happy with stolen property. So, everything belongs to Krishna. Isavasamilam sadmam. Whatever you are trying to enjoy, it is stolen property. The philosophy is tena tattena bhunjita. You can enjoy whatever is allotted to you by Krishna. Don't try to encroach upon others' property. This is real proposition for peace and prosperity. But we are trying to become the biggest enjoyer and we are trying to encroach upon others' property, others' life, others' jurisdiction. Therefore there is no peace. There cannot be peace. Therefore if we want peace at all, this is the formula. Bhoktaram jagatam sam sarvalokamayastaram sriram sarvabhutam. Krishna is the sri, is the well-wisher of everyone. Therefore he comes. Because he is the well-wisher of all living entities. If the living entities are his sons, everyone, father is always well-wisher of the son. So we are trying to enjoy here falsely, which we cannot do. Therefore Krishna comes to give us advice. Sarva dharma and paritkalya. Morning of otherwise the struggle for existence is born and will never be happy. That is Krishna consciousness moment. Thank you. Yeah.